The 2003 movie 13 starts in a meteor race where the main characters Tracy and a girl the audience is unaware of are striking each other across the face while high. The scene fades and begins 4 months earlier where Tracy is much different. She's driven, she's happy, she's a straight A student who's just beginning her middle school career. On her first day of school, she sees a popular girl named Evie. Intrigued by her, she follows her and hopes to befriend her, thus giving her the popularity and notoriety she wants. Evie gives her a false number, which Tracy learns later, but she's still desperate, so she searches for Evie at the shopping center she said that they were going to meet at. The main plot of the movie begins here with the twisting character of Tracy as she's persuaded to shoplift after seeing Evie do so. A cultural norm in society is the cultural factor of popularity and relevancy, which can cause people to lose sight of who they truly are. 13 perfectly encapsulates this cultural norm as it demonstrates how this cultural norm influences Tracy towards this cultural fantasy of popularity, which in the end ultimately destroys who she is. The cultural norm, especially among teens like Evie, holds a standard that reveres the don'ts of the world, like sex, drugs, smokes, and alcohol, on an omnipotent platform that should be continuously indulged in. Out of this is the creation of a realm of peer pressure and anxiety, because if one chooses not to indulge in it, then they'll just be ousted or bullied or viewed on a peasantry level. This realm of peer pressure tends to persuade the uninformed teen like Tracy to give in, as they don't know what they want. All they know is they don't want to be viewed as abnormal. So they give in, then they give in, then they give in. This cultural norm is of course a myth that has been conjured up somehow by society that deem these objects with such high regard. It's a dangerous myth too, because it can strip from someone their consciousness of their actions, responsibility, and sanity. The continual habit of spiraling down this cultural norm can create the habit of unconscious actions that can grow into extreme mishaps or trouble later. For instance, alcohol consumption can cause someone to have the urge to have sex, which ultimately can result in a pregnancy if not careful, which one subdued under a high blood alcohol level will not be. This action can lead to, for say, the death of a baby through abortion, or if born, will most of the time grow up in a financially hassled household, which can cause the kid to grow up parentless with the mom or dad always working. This result could have potentially occurred with Tracy, as she did have sex under the influence, and although the movie doesn't mention it, the audience can definitely infer it, because she says what any girl would say way under the age.
So you had a good time?
Yeah. But it tasted kind of nasty.
This myth can also lead to a lack in responsibility, as the movie demonstrates, where Tracy fails 3 of her classes and has to repeat 7th grade. The myth can also cause people to lose sanity, which 13 also demonstrates, where Tracy loses touch on her regular thinking, becoming angry, rebellious, fatigued, and depressed. So much so, she begins to cut herself. And it's not necessarily even the alcohol, drugs, or sex that can cause this. While they might hamper and assist the degradation of one's thoughts, relevancy and persistency and popularity are the true forces that can force someone into a social hole where that person has no time to look inward at themselves to see who they truly are. Rather, this hole they dig themselves into allows others to shape and define that individual's personality, which altogether can cause the brain to become strained with who they really are. This degradation of character is perfectly described through Tracy, as she is forced into a social hole, which as a result makes her become infuriated at the people still attached to the person she was prior to the male transformation, like her mom. This causes her brain to be pulled each way as she's falling down the rabbit hole with Evie while being thrown a rope to climb back up. The key thing that can cause a person to have a strained brain is the perception of friendship, which, like most people, like Tracy, are unable to perceive. The movie explains this phenomenon well, as it places Tracy, the unknowing, in the situation where she has to choose her friendships. The movie makes Tracy believe that Evie is her friend, while in the knowing reality, Evie is and should be someone that she simply knows. At the end of the movie, Evie betrays Tracy, making it seem as though she was the bad influencer on her, and this ultimately tears Tracy's brain as she's confused of how her friend could do this to her. In short, the movie did a fantastic job at touching the topic of cultural myth that sex, drugs, smoking, and alcohol are important things as they attach someone to the notoriety and fame. And one more thing, let me briefly touch on what can be done to deter this cultural norm, because it has a rather brief and simple answer. It all starts with the individual, and you, the individual, need to separate yourself from this perceived notoriety and realize that definition comes through you, not through how many beers you can chug, not through how many cigarettes you can smoke at once, and not through how much weed you can tote.